So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we will discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel so that you can receive all the notifications related to the recent videos. So let's begin with the very first question. Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana has been launched in Jammu and Kashmir फॉर ऑल द 21 लाख फैमिलीज, जितनी भी फैमिलीज है जम्मू एंड कश्मीर में उन सबके लिए प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना हैज बीन लॉन्च बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द स्कीम. सो गाइस इन डिटेल इस स्कीम में कुछ नहीं है, इट इज जस्ट दैट द आयुष्मान भारत हैज बीन इंप्लीमेंटेड इन द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर विद अ डिफरेंट नेम. ओके एंड द कंप्लीट नेम गाइस ऑफ द स्कीम इज व्हाट, पीएमजे प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना सेहत. ऑलराइट, this is the complete name of the scheme that has been launched in the that has been implemented in the Jammu and Kashmir for all the residents and for all the 21 lakh families of Jammu and Kashmir. So therefore the correct answer is what, option B, sehat. That is all. Isme aur zyada nahi padhna. I hope you all know about the Ayushman Bharat Yojana. Uske do components hain, ek hai Pradhanmantri Jan Arogya Yojana aur ek hai Health and Wellness Center. Pradhanmantri Jan Arogya Yojana mein government is providing 5 lakh to the families for their medical treatment for the secondary and tertiary medical facilities. All right. And now let's move on to question number 2. With which of the following two organizations, Directorate General of Training, which works under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, has inked a pact for providing a digital content for ITI students for their reskilling. So, Directorate General of Training ne ek MOU sign kiya hai with टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ताकि जो आई टी आई स्टूडेंट्स है उनको डिजिटल कॉन्टेंट प्रोवाइड करा सके फॉर देयर रीस्किलिंग एंड अपस्किलिंग. ओके सो गाइज दीज टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एंड नास्कॉम. ऑलराइट, द टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एंड नास्कॉम फाउंडेशन. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एंड नास्कॉम फाउंडेशन. एंड अंडर दिस एमओयू माइक्रोसॉफ्ट गाइज विल फैसिलिटेट एक्सेस टू द फ्री कंटेंट which is available on its Microsoft Learn platform. Okay, जो Microsoft Learn platform है उसमें जो भी digital content है Microsoft will provide the access to it. Other than this, this MOU will support the digitization of the entire document of a course, of an ongoing course which is known as Computer Operating and Programming Assistant, or in short you can say COPA, through the NASCOM Foundation. Okay, and it will benefit around 120,000 students which are there in the 3000 ITIs in our country. And guys, all these things will be done at the Bharat Skills Portal. Okay, which portal? Which is known as Bharat Skills Portal. Okay, and if we talk about guys this Bharat Skills Portal, so it is a central repository for skills which provides easy access for the trainee and trainer for the ITI ecosystem. And other than this, in addition to this, it provides access to the updated curriculum, it provides access to the question banks, past year papers, notebooks and etc. Okay, and it was launched in the year 2019 by DGT, Directorate General of Training. Okay, so therefore the correct answer should be what, Microsoft and NASCOM, which means 1 and 5. So option C guys, 1 and 5 will be the correct answer. Microsoft CEO is Satya Nadella, IBM it's Arvind Krishna, Facebook we all know Mark Zuckerberg, SOCHAM current chairperson is Dr. Niranjan Hira Nandani, and NASCOM it's UB Praveen Rao. Okay, so now let's move on to question number 3. Question number 3 is, with which department of the government of India, National Jal Jeevan Mission has launched an innovation challenge to develop portable device for water quality testing. Water quality testing ke liye portable device ko portable device banane ke liye ek innovation challenge launch kiya gaya hai under the National Jal Jeevan Mission with the in association with the Department of Government of India. So you have to tell the name of that department. There are 5 options: DPIIT, Department of Science and Technology, Department of Fisheries, Financial Services and Earth Sciences. So out of these 5 department, one department has collaborated with National Jal Jeevan Mission to organize this challenge. Okay, so let's talk about guys this challenge. So the news is innovation challenge to develop portable device for water quality testing, and the host organization guys for this challenge is what, Startup India. And who can apply for this challenge? All the startups, innovators, corporate entities or MSMEs, कोई भी apply कर सकता है इसके लिए. And the theme would be what? Water quality testing. Okay, water quality testing would be the theme. And remember, this has been launched in association with the DPIIT, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, along with the National Jal Jeevan mission. Okay. So therefore, the correct answer here should be DPIIT option A, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. And now let's move on to question number 4, which talks about PM Vriksh Ayush Yojana. So the question is, consider the following statement regarding PM Vriksh Ayush Yojana, and you have to identify the incorrect statements here. Okay. So why we are discussing about, guys, PM Vriksh Ayush Yojana, and also question number 5 is also related to the Ayush sector, which says how many Ayush health and wellness center are targeted to be operationalized till 2024. So we are discussing about the Ministry of Ayush, about the Ayush sector, because recently the year end review of the Ministry of Ayush has been launched by the ministry. So there are some key takeaways from that year end review. Let's talk about this. So there are some steps that have been taken by the Ministry of Ayush against COVID-19, which are a 3-month campaign on Ayush for immunity and telemedicine practice guidelines for Ayush, and total 104 studies are going on related to the COVID-19. Total 104 researches hain jo ki COVID-19 se related chal rahe hain in the Ayush sector. Other than this, there are two new legislations that were enacted in the Ayush sector. One is National Commission for Indian System of Medicines, and another is National Commission for Homeopathy Act 2020. And you don't have to go in detail about this act. Just remember, these two acts were enacted recently in the year 2020 through the Ministry of Ayush. And there is one institute which is known as Institute of Teaching and Research in Ayurveda that has been given the status of Institution of National Importance, and it is located in Jamnagar. And of course, Jamnagar is in Gujarat. All right. And moving ahead, so there was a WHO Global Center for Traditional Medicine that was set up in India by the Ministry of Ayush. Other than this, Ayush Health and Wellness Centers are being established since April this year. April 2020 se bahut sare Ayush Health and Wellness Center are being established under the Ayushman Bharat Yojana. All right. Under the Ayushman Bharat Yojana. And the government has a target to set up 12,500 Ayush health and wellness centers till 2024, and this year 4,400 AHWCs shall be made functional. Is saal ke ant tak 4,400 Ayush health and wellness center ko functional kar diya jayega, aur 2024 tak ka target kitna hai? 12,500. This target, guys, is very important. This can be asked in your exam. How many Ayush health and wellness centers are targeted to be operationalized till 2024? So the correct answer would be what? 12,500. Okay. And talking more about this review, so there is one champion service sector scheme which was there, which has the objective of establishment of Ayush health super Ayush healthcare super specialty hospitals, skill development in Ayush sector, and other than this, establishment of Ayush grid. Now what is this Ayush grid? So Ayush grid is basically, guys, digitization of Ayush sector through a grid. Okay, jo hamara Ayush sector hai usko kya karna hai, digitization karna hai under this project which is known as Ayush grid, and all of these things are being implemented under the champion service sector scheme. And they were setting up of 4 satellite centers of National Institutes of Ayush. Other than this, there was one scheme that was announced by the finance minister on 15th May 2020. What is the name? Pradhan Mantri Vriksh Ayush Yojana. And this has the objective of cultivation and post-harvest management of the medicinal plants. Jo hamare medicinal plants hai, unka cultivation karna aur unka jo post-harvest management hai, wo dekhna. It has a budget outlay of 4,000 crore. Okay, 4,000 crore covering 10 lakh hectare. 10 lakh hectare mein medicinal plants ka cultivation, aur jo total budget outlay hai, wo kitna hai? 4,000 crore. Other than this, this will also cover cultivation of medicine plants in an area of 800 acres along the banks of River Ganga. गंगा के किनारे 800 एकड़ में जो मेडिसिनल प्लांट्स लगाए जाएंगे वो भी अंडर दिस स्कीम होंगे, विच इज नोन एज प्रधानमंत्री वृक्ष आयुष योजना. ओके, मूविंग अहेड, टॉकिंग अबाउट द आयुष ग्रिड. सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, आयुष ग्रिड इज नथिंग बट द डिजिटाइजेशन ऑफ एंटायर आयुष सेक्टर दैट विल लीड टू द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ आयुष सेक्टर इन द फील्ड ऑफ हेल्थ एजुकेशन रिसर्च एक्सेट्रा. अदर देन दिस, इंश्योरेंस कवर. आयुष ट्रीटमेंट, गाइस, हैज बीन कवर्ड अंडर द मेडिकल इंश्योरेंस नाउ. आयुष ट्रीटमेंट पहले इंश्योरेंस कवर के नहीं, कवरेज के अंदर नहीं था, बट नाउ इट हैज बीन कवर्ड अंडर द इंश्योरेंस. एंड PFRDA, सॉरी, इंश्योरेंस रेगुलेटरी डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया हैज इश्यूड सम गाइडलाइंस रिगार्डिंग दिस. ओके, एंड दोज गाइडलाइंस आर नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम ऑफकोर्स. एंड नाउ NABH accreditation. सो फार ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ आयुर्वेदा विच इज लोकेटेड इन न्यू दिल्ली ऑफकोर्स, National Institute of Ayurveda Jaipur, and ITRA which is in Jamnagar, which also got the status of Institution of National Importance. These have been accredited by the NABH, and government strives more फॉर ऑल द हॉस्पिटल, फॉर ऑल द इंस्टीट्यूट जो भी आयुष सेक्टर में है उनको एक्रेडिटेशन मिल सके, ओके, थ्रू द NABH. सो गाइज, दिस वॉज अबाउट द ईयर एंड रिव्यू ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 and 5. एंड गाइज, दीज इन्फॉर्मेशन, देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष, एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष इज प्रमोटिंग आयुष सेक्टर अ लॉट दीज डेज. So you can expect a essay in your exam related to the IU sector, and you can use all of these points in that essay, right? And other than this, direct question can also be asked, like this question can be asked. This question can be asked setting up of WHO Center for Traditional Medicine Champion Survey Sector Scheme question can be asked. Other than this, Pradhan Mantri Viksha Ayush Yojana, that's very important question that can be asked directly. About Ayush Grid, it can be asked. Insurance coverage, it can be asked. So there are a lot of questions that can be asked from this year-end review 2020 of the Ministry of Ayush. And now let's move on to question number 4 and 5. So you have to consider the following statements regarding PM Vriksha Ayush Yojana, and you have to identify the incorrect statements. So it was announced for implementation by Prime Minister on 15th August 2020. So Prime Minister ne isko announce nahi kiya tha, it was announced by Finance Minister, and the date was 15th May. Okay, it was announced on 15th May 2020. It has the objective of cultivation and post-harvest management of medicinal plants. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Or total 10 acres mein hoga. Other than this, it has a budget outlay of rupees 5,000 crore. That is not, guys, 5,000 crore. That's how much? 4,000 crore. Which means this statement is also incorrect. So we have first and third statement which are incorrect. Option C, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. Question number 5 is, how many Ayush Health and Wellness Center are targeted to be operationalized till 2024? So, as I told you, this question is very important. And 12,500 Ayush Health and Wellness Center are targeted to be operationalized till 2024. And this year, 4,400 AWSCs shall be made operational by the end of this year. Okay. So, guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain agle session mein. And, guys, some students are asking for NFHS 5, so I'll take the session of complete NFHS 5 on 1st of January 2021 because it's a too much lengthy report, so usme time lag raha hai usko compile karne mein. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.